If you're going to study art seriously, at some point you need to ask yourself this question.
What you will and what you won't, uh-huh. What you can and what you can't, uh-huh. This is what you got to know.
How does culture form? How does culture change? There are many aspects to culture, and while there are many academic disciplines to study it, it transcends the deconstruction of its itinerant parts. It's the interaction of these parts that form a cultural system, the complex whole E.B. Tyler describes. But what happens when that system is no longer working for the prosperity of the people? Changing all parts of a system as complex and intertwined as a culture would seem impossible. But history shows us that events do cause change, sometimes slowly, sometimes quickly, sometimes dramatically, and sometimes catastrophically. But even though these changes are undeniable, many cultures also have their own take on the proverb, the more things change, the more they stay the same. Art is surely part of culture. It mirrors and expresses the ideas of a people. While the ideas of modernism, with its emphasis on aesthetic revolution and finding new forms to go with a new age, was gaining steam in European art in the early part of the 20th century, revolutionary ideas about art remained in the realm of art. Then the outbreak of events that led to the First World War brought the reality of political upheaval to the world. Could the revolutionary ideas of artists go beyond the world of art? Could art be an agent of change on the outlook of people or the outcome of events that will affect their well-being? In 1914, this crisis of culture put this idea to the test.
One bullet from a young Serbian's gun has triggered the spark for World War I, but how did one shot prove so lethal as to kill over 17 million people? It's time for the history bomb of World War I. Let's set the scene. Late 19th century Germany was booming, but there were signs of a storm brewing. Her Emperor Kaiser Wilhelm II had plans to teach his rivals a lesson.
Now Deutschland is high, but I'll take her higher. One third two syllables empire. Like Britain, I will rule sea und land. Watch out for this Vaterland.
It's worth pointing out that the Kaiser was mentally unstable, but unfortunately for the rest of Europe, he was in charge. Germany's neighbors started to take notice.
Hey, Russia, have you heard this guy? I'm thinking of putting my army on standby.
I know, cousin Willy is giving me nausea, and now he signed an agreement with Austria.
So tell her when we've got your back. We'll be here if the Kaiser attacks.
It was against this backdrop that Gavrilo Princip, a young Serbian nationalist, shot dead Archduke Franz Ferdinand, the heir to the Austrian throne, setting off a terrible chain of events. Are you ready? Let's go! Austria and Germany attack into Serbia, who allies with Russia, didn't mention that earlier. Russia get ready to advance, and that brings in their pals, yup, France. Germany attack France as quick as they can, adopt an approach called the Schlieffen Plan. They go through Belgium, awful decision, as Belgium have friends, namely Great Britain, in come Italy.
Uh-huh.
1916 in Zurich. Some artists and thinkers became convinced that the harmful obsession with reason left over from the Age of Enlightenment, the destructive forces of capitalism, and a perverse sense of nationalism had led to the war. They felt art had contributed to the decline of culture and the human spirit, and was a symbol of the bourgeois values that fed the destruction. If rationality had been corrupted, then irrationality must return. If order had led to oppression, then freedom must lay in chaos. They set out to destroy the old idea of art and replace it with a new ideal for humanity. These artists were part of a movement that came to be known as Dada. If art was meant to be beautiful, then they would celebrate the ugly. If art was meant to develop refined sensibility, then they would offend. If art was meant to show planned composition and skill, then they would use chance and make their objects from non-art materials. If art was to make sense, then they would make nonsense. By destroying the old idea of art, the Dada artists felt they could start fresh from the resulting tabula rasa.
Professor Hans Richter.
I don't have to explain Dada. You all know what Dada is. But it was created as a movement of protest in Zurich. Protest not only in the world of art, but also in the world of politics. There were immigrants from Germany, from Romania, Janko and Zara, from Austria, Zana. They were not only against the war, but they wanted to express a new kind of mentality. They wanted to include arts into the fight for a new ethic.
Poet Hugo Ball developed a form of poetry he called sound poems. His poems challenged the very notion of language and human communication.
Gatti beri bimba.
Gatti beri bimba. Glandrilalalala.
Sophie Tauber Arp made puppets and Dada costumes to accompany her dance performances. She taught at a Swiss art academy and was threatened with termination if she did not stop her Dada activity. Anna Hawk and Raul Hausman began using pictures cut from common magazines in a process known as photomontage in their work. Hausman also assembled common materials to make sculpture. Francis Boccabia was interested in the interface between man and machine.
What you do and what you don't, What you will and what you won't,
Kurt Fitters began nailing scraps of wood to his painting and eventually expanded the technique he called MERS to the Mersbau, an artwork for living.
Love you though it didn't show.
He was not against art. As a matter of fact, he created a new art form with his collage, which was completely different from anything we had seen before. And he explained to Hausmann, for instance, that he nailed his paintings and he pasted his collage in order to enrich normal paintings.
As the Zurich artists began to move around the world, the ideas of Dada began to spread. Christian Zahra was especially instrumental in spreading the ideas of Dada through his writings and travels. As Dada spread to Berlin, Cologne, Paris, Amsterdam, and New York, he expanded the way that artists approached their practice and ultimately changed the way art itself was understood. Music, dance, and theater were all influenced by Dada ideas. Max Ernst was an especially prolific artist. He founded the Dada Group in Cologne, Germany. He developed the use of frottage, or rubbings, which created chance images suggestive of organic matter. Marcel Duchamp had been active in the European avant-garde art scene, and his early work was as a painter in the Cubist style. He had been included in the Seminole Armory Show in New York in 1913. Eventually, he lost interest in painting as a form of expression and began exploring relationships between philosophy, science, and psychology. In 1915, Duchamp emigrated to New York. He had been associated with Man Ray and Boccabia and was aware of Dada ideas. He began to question the very notion of art, culture's adoration of beauty, and the value of one thing over another. He began to look for objects to which he had purely neutral response. By changing the context of these ready-made objects, they became something other than what their utilitarian purpose would suggest. When Duchamp entered his fountain in an art show in 1917, it caused an outrage. Duchamp postulated that art exists in the mind and not in the object. It changed the very nature of art from being primarily visual to primarily conceptual.
What you do and what you don't.
Techniques and approaches of the Dada artists were quite radical. They shook the very foundation of what art meant. At the time, the American Art News magazine declared, "The Dada philosophy is the sickest, most paralyzing, and most destructive thing that has ever originated in the brain of man." Adolf Hitler included the work of the Dada artists in a traveling exhibition of modern art titled Degenerate Art, meant to inflame the German populace against progressive ideas. Ironically, the anti-art of the Dada artists has become some of the most important art of the 20th century. Their legacy can be seen in almost all aspects of contemporary art that has followed. What elementary school student has not made collages from magazine pictures or sculptures from found objects? Were the Dada artists successful? Certainly they changed the way the world thinks about art, but the problems of man's self-destructive tendencies still persist. Were they a bunch of dilettantes playing in the safety of Zurich while their countrymen fought? Or were they doing what their abilities allowed them to do to fight the destruction of the war? Were their efforts significant in terms of returning culture to a more humanistic condition?
I know why you went away, Understand you couldn't stay,
In 1922, there was a funeral for Dada held at the famous art school in Germany named the Bauhaus. The energy of Dada had been absorbed into the art of the surrealists. He championed the Dada artists' support of the irrational, but not their nihilism. Every major museum in the West will have some example of Dada art as part of its collection, a fact that many Dada artists would surely find ironic and irrational. A perfectly Dada result.